Na KHPL jesteśmy w Hamburgu przed UFC, która odbędzie się za dwa dni w niedzielę 22 lipca, a ze mną jest Nasrat Haqparast. Hi Nasrat!
Hey, nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too. Look, first I would like to ask about your last fight, and it was a loss, and you've experienced a loss since you didn't experience a loss since a very, very long time. It was a first one, and you have this opportunity to unfortunately experience it. And did it influence your approach to an upcoming fight? Do you feel something different about yourself? Did you change anything when it comes to preparations to this upcoming fight?
I took the fight against Match Night with 10 days notice, and there was no fight camp. I just jumped in to get my contract with the UFC, and I think I did not bad. There were a few things I could change, but without the preparation, without the specific fight camp against a specialist like Martin Held, it's difficult to adapt in 10 days, and I didn't feel like it was a loss. Like a lot of MMA experts, they scored even the fight different, but in the end it's a loss on the paper, and nothing can hold me back, and losses are motivation always to work harder.
You know, next win can like level you up. So what you have to do is to win. And let's move on when it comes to like your experience. Let's move on to later on. So there was a UFC in London, and you've been supposed to fight there also, but you've been experiencing some eye malfunction, and the fight was like didn't happen. So is your eye okay now, and did you experience maybe some different malfunctions or injuries in the meantime?
No, it was a weird time. I was supposed to fight Alex Reyes a week before he pulled out, and we didn't have opponent, and on fight week I got a short notice opponent, and the Tuesday of fight week I got the eye infection. My eye became a little bit red, and from day to day it became worse. The UFC doctors, they took amazing care. They gave me antibiotics. Everybody tried to make the fight happen. And at the weigh-ins, I had the sunglasses to not show my eye. I thought maybe I can recover until the next day, but it was too bad. The eye infection became too big. My eye was closed. It was stick together. And in the locker room, 45 minutes before the fight, the UFC doctor, he decided to pull out. Yeah. Now, if I look back, of course it was smart. Like, we are fighters, we always want to fight. If one eye, no eyes, one arm, we always fight, you know, because you put a lot of effort in the fight camp. And after the fight got canceled, I visited some specialists in Germany, and it was a really bad eye infection, because it was not a pink eye like suspected. It was like an eye infection. I don't know the name, because... And the eye infection could go up to the brain, and that's why it was really dangerous. But I got three different medications, and it took like a month to recover from that eye infection. But now I'm healthy again.
And now you're really, really fine, because you are really showing off, especially on your Instagram when it comes to your shape and stuff. So we're supposing that your preparations went very nice, and you've been training in Tristar Gym in Canada with GSP. Can you tell us something more about this, what happened in your life recently?
Yes, that was my, I think, 6 or 7 visit in Tristar Gym, and my second camp this year at Tristar. And this camp was amazing. It was really specific. Josh helped me a lot. GSP is actually a good friend of mine now. My head coach, Faraz Sahabi, is a genius. He put together an amazing fight camp, and we did everything right, I think, and Sunday we're going to show.
What you've been focusing on when it comes to preparations, the grappling, stand-up, takedowns, I don't know, what was the core of your preparations of your camp this time?
I have the best coaches in every discipline. I have a good strength conditioning coach, I have a good nutritionist, striking coach, head coach, and we focus on everything, of course, and if it comes closer to fight, we focus on some specific game plan things, and this time we had a lot of time to prepare on one opponent, and Mark is a specialist in something, so we could put together a good game plan and drill it for the weeks.
Being the youngest fighter in the whole organization in the UFC, is it kind of a tension for you, or maybe more like a motivation? How do you feel about that? Is it very, very stressful for you to be that young and be in the biggest organization in the world when it comes to mixed martial arts?
Actually, I'm the youngest in Europe. I think there are a few guys, two or three guys younger than me in America, but I think I have experience. I travel a lot, and I really think that hard work gives you a lot of confidence. That's why I don't feel any pressure if I fight in front of 20,000 people in my hometown or in front of five people in whatever in Brazil. There's no pressure because I'm prepared.
Yeah, while doing this research on the fact whether you're the youngest or not, we've been comparing with Sean O'Malley, but he's 1 year older than you, and also Mark Degis, and he was born in March, and you're in August, so a couple of months, he's still older, so probably you're like the youngest in Europe, maybe even in the world. Yeah, and tell us something more about the face-off that we've been experiencing like a few minutes ago, and a lot of tension between you two, you and your opponent. Why is that? Do you have any personal issues between two of you?
No, I don't have any personal issues, never with my opponent. My opponent is just my opponent. He's just a human I face. It's a competition. I did my job. I'm going to do my job on Sunday. And there's no bad blood. Why should I have emotions? If you put emotions into something and get emotional, you can't stick to the game plan. You're not professional anymore, you know? So if you're professional and if you're ready for a fight, never put emotions, because emotions make you weak.
So Nasrat, thank you so much for the talk, and good luck on your Sunday's performance.
Thank you very much.